Last time we explored the history of Nathan Smith and Dartmouth Medical College. Today we will be looking at Yale University, where he went to next. My uncle John actually was a professor at Yale University. Go into any library and look up dinosaurs, and you will find my uncle John's name. He was a famous paleontologist who discovered the Deinonychus. He was a professor at Yale University, and while working there in the 1960s, he went on several expeditions to Montana. On one of those digs, he discovered a new species of dinosaur with a large, terrible claw. He named the dinosaur Deinonychus, which means terrible claw. But his greatest discovery was what he found out about Deinonychus, which revolutionized the way we see dinosaurs. He noticed that the Deinonychus was very bird-like. He spent the rest of his life studying fossils with feathers and other bird-like characteristics. My Uncle John's love of dinosaurs started when he was a teenager. In 1950, their family went on a trip around the United States to visit national parks, and one of those parks was Dinosaur National Park. In 2011, we took a trip to see the dinosaur tracks along the Connecticut River in Holyoke, Massachusetts. We heard that my Uncle John did some research there back in the 70s.
And I said,
I found another one!
Right
here. I found another one.
Is it going? Is there one right there? There's one over here.
No,
here.
At the site, there's some information about my Uncle John's visit. It says, in the early 1970s, Yale University professor John Ostrom identified these tracks as being from three distinct, though related, dinosaurs. Another plaque reads, "The most remarkable part about Professor Ostrom's work was his determination that almost all of the 134 footprints he studied were part of 28 distinct trackways leading in a very nearly the same direction. The tracks at this site thus documented for the first time that some dinosaurs were not always solitary, but tended to travel as a herd, pack, or flock." My grandfather's name was William Ostrom. He had an expectation that one of his sons would take on the family profession of ophthalmology. But John had no interest in his father's line of work. My father, Andrew, ended up taking on the family profession so John could pursue his passion of archaeology and paleontology. Dr. John Ostrom joined the Yale faculty in 1961. He wrote many scientific books. In 1970, while visiting a museum in the Netherlands, he made his second notable discovery when he recognized that a fossil skeleton labeled Parasaur was actually a prehistoric bird called Archaeopteryx. He saw similarities in his own discovery of Deinonychus, and in 1973 he proposed the theory that birds evolved from dinosaurs. So we're in New Haven, Connecticut. So this is the grave of Nathan Smith, and he is the founder of Dartmouth Medical College and also the co-founder of the medical program at Yale University. So this is the campus of Yale University. Yeah. So one of these buildings is where my Uncle John taught. I can't remember which one. Graduation party? This is the old campus of Yale University. So here is where Nathan Smith might have taught, here at the old campus of Yale. Nathan Smith was one of the first professors of anatomy and medicine at Yale University. He started teaching at Yale in 1813. Nathan Smith was much sought after by Yale University, but also other universities, such as UVM and Bowdoin University. He went up to Bowdoin University for a while in 1822 and served on their faculty. But then he stayed on as on Yale's faculty. And in 1826, he committed himself to only Yale University. This is the University of Vermont. And so Nathan Smith helped establish the medical program here. He didn't teach here, but his son Nathan Rhino Smith did. There's some really neat architecture here. Here's downtown Burlington. Here's Lake Champlain. Look at all those boats. He worked at Yale University as a professor until 1828, when he came down with an illness that left him debilitated, and the illness progressively got worse and he passed away January 26, 1829. Yale Law School. Here we go, let's see.
Skeleton.
about the size of that. And over here we have, this is the Velociraptor skeleton here. And this is like in Jurassic Park. You have the version of what they call Velociraptor, but this is actually closer to the Deinonychus size than the Velociraptor. John retired from Yale in 1992. In 1997, one of his last scientific forays, Dr. Ostrom joined an expedition to China that unearthed new forms of dinosaurs with feathers, providing further credence to his ideas. Dr. John Ostrom passed away July 16, 2005. These two Yale professors left their own legacies and revolutionized their field of science. The evidence of science can't be denied, but also the connections of the spirit can't be denied. The tree of life, the scientific tree of life of evolution, and the spiritual tree of life found in many religions, the eternal tree of life.